students, today we are going to discuss about resonance in AC circuit. So before entering into the topic, so you must understand little bit about AC circuit. So the circuit theory involves five components: two active components, three passive components. The active components are current source and voltage source. The passive components are resistance, inductance and capacitance. So it may be either in series connected or parallel connected. But in DC circuit, the circuit that involves only resistance. So Ohm's law, according to Ohm's law, I is equal to what? I is equal to V by R, because it consists of only resistance. But AC circuit is concerned, it is the combination of resistance, inductance and capacitance. So how will you call this collectively? It is called impedance. So according to Ohm's law, I is equal to V by Z for AC circuit. Similarly, when the impedance are in series, Z is equal to R1 plus, Z is equal to Z1 plus, Z2 plus, Z3. Similarly, when impedance are in parallel, 1 by Z is equal to 1 by Z1 plus 1 by Z2 plus 1 by Z3. So here, you must understand first, what is the impedance of resistance, what is the impedance of inductance and what is the impedance of capacitance. Because, so AC circuit involves these three components. What are they? It is the resistance, inductance and capacitance. So first of all, you must know what is the value of, what is the impedance of resistance, what is the impedance of capacitance and what is the impedance of resistance. The impedance of resistance is equal to R. So there is no change in that. For DC also it is R, AC also it is R. There is no change. The unit is Ohm. The impedance of inductor is equal to J into XL. So how will you represent the inductor? J into XL. Where XL is equal to inductive reactance, it is equal to omega into L, that is equal to 2 pi FL. So the impedance of inductor is equal to J into XL. Similarly, the impedance of capacitance is equal to minus J into XC. The unit is Ohm. XC is equal to 1 by omega C. That is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Omega is equal to 2 pi FC. So what is omega? Omega is equal to angular frequency. The unit is radian per second. RAD per second SEC. Similarly, some of the important tips you must know in this. For example, if you look into this, it is an inductor. As well as, this is called inductive reactance. There is no difference between the representation of an inductor and inductive reactance. Where the variation comes means the unit. For example, 2 Henry. It is not an inductive reactance. It is the value of an inductor. 2 Farad. It is not the value of capacitive reactance. It is the value of capacitor. What you see here, it is 2 Ohm. It is not inductor. It is the value of XL. When you are writing this, how will you represent J into 2? So as you see here, it is 2 Ohm. It is a value of capacitive reactance. How will you represent a capacitive reactance? Minus J into XC. So it is a value of XC. So minus J into 2. So this is very, very important. Most of the students will do a mistake here, because they directly write J into 2. Actually, J into 2 pi FC, that's not an inductive reactance. They directly write J into 2, because the given value is L, not XL. But here the given value is XL, so you can write J into 2. Here the given value is capacitive reactance XC, so you can write minus J into XC, because capacitance is denoted by minus J into XC in AC. Similarly, the frequency also, sometimes some of the problem they will give frequency of 50 hertz or cycles per second. So that is the value of F. So sometimes they will give frequency of 50 radian per second. So it is the value of omega. So don't confuse this, because frequency means normally we will take F, but here the given is radian per second. So radians per second, it is the value of omega, not F. So you must be very careful enormous value. Suppose if they represented like this, 1030 volt, 1030 ampere. So these are the RMS values. Sometimes in a problem, they will give like this. That is 10 sin 50 volt. Instead of 1030 volt or 1030 volt, they are represented like this. 10 sin 50 volt. So here it is means that Vm sin omega t. AC can be represented by Vm sin omega t, AC voltage. So this is the value of Vm, V maximum. We are not using maximum in problems. We are using RMS value of the voltage. So we have to convert this into RMS value. Vr is equal to, first you have to 10 divided by root 2. So that value you can use in the problems. So don't confuse this RMS value and the maximum value. Similarly, 50 is the omega value. Sin Vm sin omega t. So 10 is Vm, but we are not using Vm in the problem. We are using RMS value. So you have to convert it to RMS value. In this case alone. So 10 divided by root 2. So here you see here 20 sin 30 t. It is Im sin omega t. Normally AC current is represented by Im sin omega t. So this is the value of Im. So in the problem we are using only RMS value. So you convert this Im into RMS value by 20 divided by root 2. So whether it is needed for this, directly they are giving 10 and then whether it is required to convert divided by root 2, no. Because the given is RMS value, they never mention the RMS value, the voltage. So voltage of 10 and 30, that means it is the RMS value. So no need to convert this into a RMS value. Already given is RMS value, but here the given is maximum value, Vm sin omega t. So this is also important tips. You must be very careful when you are solving the problems in resonance. Now we are going to discuss resonance in AC circuit. First of all, which type of circuit we can achieve resonance? The circuit consists of resistance, inductance and capacitance. These three components are mandatory to achieve resonant condition. So which type of circuit we can convert that circuit into resonant circuit? The circuit that involves resistance, inductance and capacitance. You may ask whether RL circuit we can achieve resonance. Not possible. RC circuit, it is not possible. It must consist of resistor, inductor and capacitor. That is mandatory. Either it may be in series or it may be in parallel. That is, doesn't matter. But it involves resistance, inductance and capacitance. So what is resonance? An AC circuit is said to be resonance if it behaves like a pure resistive circuit. Actually, AC circuit means that consists of resistance, inductance and capacitance. When this circuit behaves like a pure resistive circuit, then the circuit is said to be resonance. So why are these resonance circuits are used? Means in the communication network, these resonance circuits are used. When the circuit is AC circuit is said to be resonant, it behaves like a pure resistive circuit. So both current and voltage are in same phase. The power factor is unity. Normally AC circuit, the power factor is not unity. It must be leading power factor or lagging power. It must be below 1. But at resonance, the AC circuit power factor is unity because it is behaving like a pure resistive circuit. So at resonance, normally the formula for I in AC circuit is equal to V by Z. I is equal to V by Z. But at resonance, I is equal to V by R. It is not Z. I is equal to V by R. Not it is Z because so the circuit is behaving like a only resistive circuit. Though it consists of inductance and capacitance, but it is behaving like a resistive circuit. So I is equal to V by R only. It is only at resonance. Normal case AC circuit, I is equal to V by Z. But at resonance, I is equal to V by R. So the current is maximum at resonance because the denominator is less. Instead of Z, the denominator is R. So the current is maximum at resonance. The power factor is unity at resonance. So how we can achieve the resonant condition in the AC circuit means by varying three parameters we can achieve resonance in the AC circuit. One is by varying the inductance. Second one is by varying the capacitance. Third one is by varying the frequency. Now, capacitor by varying the frequency. By varying these three parameters, we can achieve resonance in AC circuit. So first we will discuss resonance in series RLC circuit. So it is, so R, L, C are connected in series. So how the resonance condition can be achieved in this? So normally, so AC circuit, I told that it is impedance, is it? Here the three components are connected in series. You may already know that impedance of Z is equal to, impedance of R is equal to R. Impedance of L is equal to J into XL. Impedance of C is equal to minus J into XC. So Z is equal to Z1 plus, Z2 plus, Z3. Where Z1 is R, Z1 is J, Z2 is J into XL, and Z3 is minus J into XC. So Z is equal to R plus J into XL minus J into XC. So we can take J common, so we have to take J outside. Z is equal to R plus J into XL minus XC. When XL is equal to XC, what will happen? The J common is equal to 0. When XL is equal to XC means this is 0. So Z is equal to R. So the circuit is behaving like a resistive circuit. Right? So the condition for resonance in series RLC circuit is when XL is equal to XC, Z is equal to R, the circuit is behaving like a pure resistive circuit. So the series RLC circuit is said to be resonance. Then we will discuss how to calculate the resonance frequency in series RLC circuit. Resonance frequency. Now what is meant by resonance frequency? The frequency at which resonance occurs is called resonance frequency. The frequency at which resonance occurs is called resonance frequency. So now we are going to derive the formula to calculate resonance frequency. So here, the condition for resonance in series RLC circuit, from that we are going to derive that. What is the condition for resonance in series RLC circuit? So condition for resonance in series RLC circuit is XL is equal to XC. So XL is equal to what? 2 pi FL. So this is the condition for resonance. So instead of F, we are adding FR, resonance frequency, FR. So normally XL is equal to 2 pi FL. So here this is the condition for resonance. So we are adding a small R here, it's called resonance frequency. So XL is equal to 2 pi FRL equal to XC is equal to, you know that, 1 by 2 pi FRC. So you take FR in one side, remaining term in the other side. So FR in FR, that's called FR square is equal to 1 by 2 square pi square LC. So if you find the root of on both sides, FR is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of LC. So this is the formula to calculate the resonance frequency of series RLC circuit. So resonance frequency of series RLC circuit is what? FR is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of LC.